Gears 5. Without having to say or do anything, the title of the latest entry in this long-running franchise sums it up perfectly. A clear nod to its past, while also embracing a new identity, a new future. Gears 5 pays homage to its legacy, while simultaneously paving the way towards new horizons. Gears 5 initially picks up right where Gears of War 4 left off. JD, Del, Kate, and Marcus are investigating a site stowed away on a lush tropical island. While the Cog are looking for new weapons to help against the Swarm, Kate continues to struggle with her legacy and the visions they haunt her with. What follows is the most transformative Gears experience yet. The opening chapter is essentially a love letter to Gears as we all have known it. Dark, linear, and straightforward combat encounters with the classic cover-based gunplay that has become the industry standard. Some nice set pieces, satisfying explosions, and off we go. As soon as the pyrotechnics fade, however, something new takes place. And this is where Gears starts to show change. An entire chapter where the action is non-existent to allow for story beats and character development to take place. It's a radical change, and throwing it right after an explosive opening is a nice way to make the sudden change of pace accommodating. Despite many critics relegating the Gears franchise to dumb bro shooter, these games have created a compelling universe with fantastic characters. Are they over the top? Of course, but that doesn't stop them from having a ton of heart and attachments to this world and its stories. Allowing for a moment to stop and take it all in and see what's happened since Gears 4 was an excellent decision. The Coalition also uses this moment to introduce a new gameplay element, most notably long-standing favorite Jack, the best floating robot companion in gaming. I'm sorry, Destiny fans. Jack was always a core member of the Delta Squad, but now he has a significant gameplay presence. Players can find components, a new collectible that allows Jack to be upgraded and obtain several useful active and passive combat abilities. Jack can even be played as in the co-op campaign or in Horde mode. Once we get past the game's opening moments and are thrust into the gigantic hub area riding a skiff, we are pretty far from the Gears we all know and onto something new and experimental. Secret areas, character interactions, and relic weapons are hidden in a drop-dead, gorgeous frozen tundra. This is the moment where the title really hits home. At its core, the cover-based gunplay in combat is the best it's ever been. However, they aren't afraid to stow the guns away to allow for moments of mundane to fill the gaps between those battles. It isn't too dissimilar from lessons God of War learned and implemented last year. At some point, running room to room to take cover and fight relentlessly grows tiresome. We've had those kinds of experiences for a decade. It's time for a change, and for the most part, Gears 5 pulls it off with finesse. The duality of the plot can sometimes clash with the new gameplay experiences the open world areas can bring. Kate's journey mostly dissipates for a large chunk of the campaign, and ramifications of her journey don't reappear to the last hour or so. It feels as if they hesitated to go all the way with her story. The marketing hinted at something dangerous and truly wild, but outside a few early moments, they never take her story anywhere near its potential. Outside of Kate's individual story, the rest of the game's plot fares better. War is back, and the Cog vs. Swarm battle is in full effect, and some true gut punches and shocking moments will leave everybody waiting for the conclusion to this new trilogy. Gears 5 is also just that, a firm middle chapter. It has some of the same issues that nearly every middle child has, the delicate balance of following a story and building towards a conclusion that it won't reach itself. It succeeds, and it manages to find a great point for the story to end on. Gameplay-wise, this is Gears through and through. A handful of new weapons and Jack's much upgraded arsenal are the biggest highlights. Melee combat is also a much more viable tactic, and some battles even allow for moments of brief stealth before settling into the bombast you'd expect from a typical Gears firefight. The skiff and exploring the world provide the biggest departure in terms of structure, and as a mode of transport, the skiff was a blast to pilot. Outside of campaign, Horde and Versus are back with significant improvements. Now, I'm not a slide-shoddy guru, nor will I ever be one, so the new arcade deathmatch is perfect. A nice blend of action and ideas that allow for those less versed in the Nasher to flex some competitive muscle and have a good time. Escape is the lone new mode and is a fun yet brief three-player activity which sees the players trying to make it out of a hive-infested location while poison gas gives chase. The lack of ammo and weapons combined with the tension of the creeping gas make Escape a great new mode. It's hard, but packs a lot of action and a small 15 to 20 minute burst, which is a perfect companion to the much longer and more involved horde mode. Last but not least, I'd be remiss not to mention the game's absolutely drop-dead visuals. Graphics are absolutely taken for granted lately, as most games tend to look better than not. Gears 5, however, is a monster. Absolutely huge vistas and gorgeous set pieces are delivered at a crispy 4K and 60 frames per second on the Xbox X, and the PC port is phenomenal. Overall, Gears 5 is a great game, but it isn't perfect. My experience was marred by server issues that would cause severe hitches and frequent disconnects. Now, most of these are server-side, but while my 16-hour campaign had 4 hours of that occupied by disconnects, that's not acceptable. Outside of the technical issues, the main plot had a satisfying conclusion, but Kate's individual story just doesn't live up to its promise. Hopefully, Gears 6 will do her justice, but that doesn't make her lack of growth feel better in the moment. Outside of my gripes with her story, I did have a blast with the campaign, and the rest of the package is Gears at its best. Overall, I give Gears 5 an 8 out of 10. I really enjoyed the campaign. I enjoyed the overall plot. I just wish some of the individual characters were given a little bit more meat to them to make some of the bigger moments truly hit home. And the progression is so much better than before. I can see myself playing it for a much longer time than Gears 4. I hope you enjoy my review. Stay tuned for a lot more coming up in September. And have a great one, everybody.
Hey. What are you...
Why did you come here with me? What did JD tell you?
This is...